Hi, I'm Aliana Cai. In today's video, I will teach you how to create a mockup by Figma. A mockup is a high fidelity design that represents your final product. So by the end of today's video, you will be able to recreate a screen that looks exactly the same as a screenshot of your favorite app. This is the second episode of my Figma tutorial series, so please check out the previous one on how to create a wireframe before jumping to this video. Let's get started. This is what we built last time, and let's start from here. On the left side, we have the screenshot of the app that we want to duplicate. On the right, we have the wireframe that we created. The first thing I will do is to copy the wireframe frame and then paste it here, move it to the bottom so that we keep a storage of what we built. Let's rename the top right frame to mockup. By the end of this video, we shall be able to turn this mockup frame into exactly how the left side looks like. To do that, we need to adjust the size, color, and position of every single element. Let's start from the largest element, the image. Let's drag the rectangle in our wireframe on top of the screenshot. Then let's zoom into every single corner, adjust the rectangle so that the size and the location perfectly overlaps the image. You can see that the right size will be 375x375 for this image on Instagram. Now let's drag this rectangle back to the mockup frame. To horizontally drag an element, hold Shift and it won't change the vertical location. Once the vertical red line shows up throughout the screen, it means you've centrally aligned this element. So let go of your mouse once you see the red line shows up. The selected element will always be highlighted in blue on the left side, but you might need to scroll up and down to find the element. And let's double click on it to rename it. To fill an element with a photo, please first prepare the high resolution photo in your local device. Select the photo in your local device and then press Ctrl-C or Command-C. Then let's go back to Figma, select the element, and then press Ctrl-V or Command-V. On the right-hand side, underneath Fill, we can see that we are filling a rectangle by an image. Now we are done with creating the largest element in our mockup. Let's quickly check whether there's any minor element within this large element. Indeed, there is one. This is a carousel post, so there's a 1/3 label on the top right of the image. But in our mockup frame, the image is covering the 1/3 label. To fix this problem, we need to adjust the layers. So let's go to the left-hand side, drag the photo layer all the way to the bottom so the other layers can show up on top of it. And this element is really two elements. First is the gray background and the other is the text element. Let's drag the rectangle on top of the screenshot. Again, let's adjust the size so that all the edges are perfectly lined up. Now let's round these corners. Go to the right panel and pay attention to the second panel. Use the 6th control to adjust the angle size. Here, I'm going to set the angle radius to the maximum. Now the shape looks right. Let's adjust the color. Select the element, select Fill, and then use the color picker. Then select the original element color. Great! Now what we need to do is to put it back to the original location. We also need to figure out the horizontal location. So let's measure the space here. A brute force way of measuring anything is to simply create a rectangle, and then you can just read it from the width of this rectangle. Here it is 13 pixels. Usually we can just look at the x and y coordinate on the top right, but sometimes it won't work if we are not working within a frame, which is the current situation with this screenshot. So let's hold Shift again, drag it to the right frame. On the x coordinate, I'm going to minus it by 13 pixels. That will make sure it will be placed in the right location. As a recap, to create a mockup for a shape element, let's first make sure it has the right size and the right shape. Then let's give it the right color. And finally, let's adjust it to the right location. It's also a great practice to give the element a proper name. Now let's work on the text element. The text is currently covered by the upper element. So first let's drag it to the top. Then let's drag it on top of the screenshot to compare the size. You can change the font size, the color on the right. For now, I will first adjust the color. I will use the color picker again to select the white color. Then I will adjust the font size until it overlaps better. And move it back to the original frame. There are a few ways to center two elements. Well, the first way is to just move it around until the two red lines show up. Another way is to hold Shift on your keyboard and then select two elements. Then click the aligning icons on top. Click the center icon vertical and then click the center icon horizontal. I cannot really get access to Instagram font, so I'll be using the font Inter for this project. As a recap, to refine a text element in the markup, the key things we need to pay attention to are the font size, the font color, and the position. Now let's use the same method to refine all the other shape elements and text elements. As a kind reminder, we're just trying to make a copy of an existing app. While in an actual user experience or user interface design project, you will be the person that actually makes decision when it comes to the right spacing, the right color, the right font sizes. But don't worry, if you're working with a company, usually your company will have other designers who's in charge of designing a design system, and they will be providing you the right font, sizes, and colors that you can use, so you don't have to worry about how to make those decisions. However, there's an exception when you are the only designer or you're working with a very early startup. In those cases, you will also be the one who make decisions for the color, the font. It's going to be challenging, but it will be fun. And the only best way to do it is to first practice, and second, learn from other product. Here I'm seeing a shape that has a border on it. So let's select the element to add a border. Let's add stroke. Then we can adjust the color or adjust where the stroke is being placed. And now I'm just going to select the right color again from the original screenshot to give it the right stroke color. Here we go. Another fun fact, and this time about text element, is that many products actually don't use the default spacing size. And this is an example here. To adjust the spacing size, let's just go to the red panel again and use this field to adjust the spacing. Just like this. Now let's keep going. Sometimes you might face the problem where your mouse or keyboard just cannot control the spacing precise enough to make your element be in the location that you want it to be. Just like this scenario. Or in this kind of case, you'll have to go to the right panel and then type in the position. You might just need to minus or plus 0.5 pixel. Here we go. And if we treat every element separately, we'll end up having a canvas full of separate elements. So in this scenario, it will be helpful if we just select all of these dots and then use Command G to group this into a group. We can name this group into See More button, and then that will be more helpful than keeping these dots separately. Let's keep going to refine all the other elements. While you're doing it, you might find it pretty fun to look at how precisely these apps actually set themselves up. You might also realize that it takes so much time to create all these details, especially in comparison to the last episode where we learned how to create a wireframe. And that is why designers usually create a wireframe before jumping into designing these details. And my suggestion to you is to always create a wireframe first. Figure out what structure you are going to use before jumping into refining these details, because this will sunk up a lot of your time, and please don't waste time designing for a structure that you are not even going to use. If you're confused about any element, just jump back to the previous part of the video because I've already covered how you can realize any element that you want. And the hardest part of being a UI or UX designer is really not about how to use this tool, but rather how to make the best design decision, working within constraints, collaborating with engineers and PMs, and also design a product that users will like and design a product that your company can actually make. We're almost there. And by now, the only elements that you might not have finished are the icons. So now I'll teach you how to refine these icons. The good news is that 99% of the time, you don't have to design any of the icon by yourself. For now, let's access the templates that's available online. To do that, let's go to Figma homepage, and then let's go to the Figma community page. On the top, let's select icons. Now, these are resources that's dedicated to icons template. You can use any of these resources. Choose the one that you like. For my project, I'm going to use a file that's named under cool icons. Once you duplicate the file, you'll open something that looks like this. Here, you can try to find the icons that you need and simply just copy and paste them to your project to use it. Here, I'm selecting the like icon, copy it, and then pasting it in my project. Again, I will drag it on top of my screenshot to figure out the precise sizing and also the precise location. Please hold Shift on your keyboard if you don't want to change the ratio between the width and the length of this icon. Now let's look at the selection colors. Please click the unlink icon to unlink the original selection color, and then select the actual red color that you want to use. Or you can use a black color to represent a post that's not liked yet. Just like what we've done before, let's again figure out the right position and then move it to the right place in the right frame. Now let's do the same for all the other icons. While you're doing it, you might encounter a scenario where you have to flip an icon to make it right. To do that, simply right-click on the icon and then select Flip Horizontally. Let's keep going. If you encountered a scenario where you just cannot find the exact icon, don't worry, just use a similar one for now. We're not trying to be perfect in this practice. When it comes to icons, you might be surprised how many icons there actually are in a screenshot. These are something that we don't pay attention to as a user because good designs are often invisible. So next time when you are using your favorite app, pay attention to these icons, and that could be a great inspiration for your next project. Now we're pretty much finished for this mockup screen, but there's just one more details we need to add, and let's see what's the difference. And the answer is the system-related elements. These are things that come with your mobile. For example, the time and the battery percentage on top of the screen. These are also super important for a mockup. To add these elements, let's go to the Figma community page again, and let's search the system that you have on your mobile phone. For my project, I'll be using the iOS kit. Once you open the kit, not every element will be shown on the thumbnail page, so make sure you're in the right page. And in this case, I'll go to the component page. Now, the only thing we need to do is to have some patience and try to find the right element for the top of your screen and the bottom of your screen. Once you find it, copy it and paste it to your mockup. Here's a reminder that if you're creating a design on your own, you should be copying these elements before you do the detailed mockup design. This is because we don't want to make a design without considering these elements being on top and bottom of the screen. If we don't place this before we make the design, we might design it on top of elements and then end up having to adjust all the other elements. And that's it! We've finished the mockup for the screen. Congratulations! You learned a lot about mockup today. Let me know in the comment section below whether you want to take this even one step further to make it an interactive prototype. So please comment a victory sign emoji if you want to see that video coming. Please subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications because more tutorial and design content is coming up. Also, I have a new Instagram account at @thealianacai, so please follow that as well. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.